As the requisite quorum is present, I declare the meeting is in order. Dear member, I'm also glad to introduce my fellow directors, the board, for this meeting. This is Amita Mishra, independent director, Mr. Desa Dubra, independent director, Mr. T. H. Vishwanathan, independent director and chairman of the audit committee. Mr. Rajkumar Jain, independent director and chairman of the audit committee. This is Mr. Ashok, independent director. Rajesh Mandaiwala, non-executive director. Mr. Vishal Bhatti, managing director and CEO.
Unmute.
We are not able to hear.
Can you hear now?
Yeah.
Yes.
As the notice convening this 25th annual general meeting and the auditor's report along with the audited financial statement for the year ended March 31st, 2020 have been to the members and available on the website of the company and stock exchanges. I take the notice and the auditor report as read. I now proceed to say a few words and then to practice the business as per the agenda given to the notice. I would request Deep to take it forward. Let me start by wishing everyone safety and health for you and your family and friends. I would also like to thank for attending this virtual annual general meeting, 25th annual general meeting of our company. This year, 1920, the year 1920 which just passed by, has been one of the most challenging years in the recent times of global economy. The world is currently going through the COVID-19 crisis, disrupting not only health and healthcare system, but the complete economic system of the globe. Even in these challenging times, your company grew from strength to strength, breaking all its previous records on production, sale and profitability. The company has shown consistent growth during the year, reflecting the operational excellence and efficiency in all the three geographies, that is India, USA and Saudi, where your company is present, having a manufacturing facility in all these geographies. Let me take you through key highlights of last financial year of your company. Total income crossed the milestone of the rupees 10,000 crore, which was the first time in the history of the company. Sales volume at record 1.502 million ton. All-time high operated EBITDA at rupees 1,284 crores. Profit after tax was rupees 674 crores and EPS was per share was 25 rupees. The current financial year started with the oil and gas industry facing a double whammy: demand destruction due to COVID-19 and failed talks between OPEC plus countries, leading to a ruthless war for market share, resulting into a supply glut. However, now we are seeing improvement both in oil prices and consumption. In fact, we announced receipt of multiple orders of approximately 106,000 tons across geographies at the starting of this month, reflecting the improved business sentiment. There is still uncertainty associated with prolonged COVID-19 and consequently on CapEx programs of the global E&P and midstream companies. Even in this scenario, India offers a potentially bright outlook. The company is leveraging the changing market dynamics, growing potential, and increasing industry opportunities to convert that into growth by exploring new markets. I'm extremely pleased to inform that one of the significant highlights of the year is that your company has become completely debt-free on a net debt basis. The company has utilized its cash flow to repay loans, buyback of shares, and substantially dividend payment during the year 2020. The company would continue to use the cash flow optimally and will also explore organic and inorganic growth opportunities with expansions of product portfolio at an appropriate time and value. To provide liquidity for its investment, your company has now decided to list its joint venture company, that is Welspun Middle East Private Limited, in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia at the local stock exchanges there, subject to necessary approvals and prevailing market condition. Over the next few months, we will be listing this JV. In this process, your company would divest maximum up to 15% of the total issued share of the joint venture. Welspun Corp Limited has always been at the forefront of research and development to prepare itself for future technological advancement, and consistently been involved in upgrading of technology and in technology with innovation in digitization as well as the automation. Our experienced technical experts are actively involved in various joint industrial projects to resolve technical issues for oil and gas pipeline globally with customers and their customers. In line with group philosophy of continuous learning, your company provides training to employees through capacity building workshops, specialized subject specific training programs, and online training intervention. Your company over the last few years has launched several learning and employee development initiatives like V-Learn Portal, Future Leadership Program, Group Leadership Program, and Technical Center of Excellence. These are some initiatives designed to help employees enhance their skill and gain relevant experience. The company believes in adhering to compliance and responsible management in order to attend the highest level of good corporate citizenship. Your company boards.
Can we request everyone to keep their microphones on mute, please? NSDL team, please mute the other participants, please.
A detailed report of our corporate governance practices is included in our annual report for your reference. Friends, due to this crucial time, your company has taken all possible steps to minimize the impact of COVID-19. We have continued our focus on strengthening customer relationship, employee safety, cost optimization, as well as looking at the cash collection and accelerating the digital adoption. We are quite confident that your company will weather this storm successfully and going to have a win-win scenario with our supplier as well as the customer. With these words, I would like to conclude by expressing my sincere gratitude to the members, bankers, customers, board members, and all the employees. I hope you and your family members and colleagues are well and are taking necessary safety measures. Stay safe, stay happy. Thank you very much. Now I request the secretary to explain the resolution to the members.
Thank you, sir. Good morning, dear chairman, other dignitaries and members present in the meeting. You must be aware we had provided remote e-voting from 9 a.m. on August 28, 2020 to 5 p.m. on August 30, 2020. Still, if any of you has not participated in the remote e-voting, will get an opportunity to cast vote. Such members are requested to visit the website of NSDL and go to voting page to cast their vote while the meeting continues. The electronic voting facility shall close after 15 minutes from the conclusion of this meeting. Since the meeting is held through video conferencing, there will be no proposing and seconding of the resolutions by the members. The company has appointed Mr. Mihan Alani, proprietor of Messrs. Mihan Alani and Associates, practicing company secretary, as a scrutinizer to scrutinize the e-voting and remote e-voting process. Dear members, there are 8 resolutions proposed for approval by the members. Resolution number 1, as an ordinary resolution for adoption of the financial statements for the financial year ended March 31, 2020. And the report of the directors and the auditors thereon. There are no qualifications in the report of the statutory auditor as well as in the secretarial audit report issued by the secretarial auditor on the financial statements. Resolution number 2, as an ordinary resolution for declaration of dividend for the financial year ended March 31, 2020 at the rate of 10%, that is rupees 50 paisa per equity shares. Resolution number 3 is an ordinary resolution for reappointment of Mr. Vipul Mathur, who retires by rotation and being eligible, offers himself for reappointment. Brief resume of Mr. Mathur is given in the notice of the meeting, which has already been circulated to the members. Mr. Mathur, being the appointee, is interested in this resolution. Resolution number 4 is an ordinary resolution for reappointment of Mr. B.K. Goenka, who retires by rotation and being eligible, offers himself for reappointment. Brief resume of Mr. Goenka is given in the notice of the meeting. Mr. Goenka, being the appointee, and his wife, Mrs. Dipali Goenka, being a shareholder, are interested in this resolution. Resolution number 5, as an ordinary resolution for ratification of fees of rupees 7 lakhs per annum payable to Mr. Kiran Jay Mehta, who are our cost accountant, for their appointment as the cost auditor for the financial year 2021. Resolution number 6, as a special resolution for authority to raise funds up to rupees 500 crores through private placement. Resolution number 7, as a special resolution for payment of remuneration by way of commission at the rate of 1% of the net profits of the company to Mr. Goenka, who is our non-executive chairman. His brief resume is given in the notice of the meeting. Mr. Goenka, being the beneficiary under this resolution, and his wife, Mrs. Dipali Goenka, being a shareholder, are interested in this resolution. The last resolution is a special resolution for listing and offer for sale of partial investments in Welspun Middle East Pipes LLC, a step-down subsidiary and joint venture of the company's Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Dear Chairman, over to you now.
What about other resolution?
Resolution I explained.
The resolutions and the procedure for voting has been explained. I request the member to proceed to cast their votes. In the meanwhile, we shall answer the queries received from the member.
Sir, we have received some queries. You allow we can take yes, some of the queries. First query is, what is the ratio of business into water segment and oil and gas segment? And considering the drop in the oil prices resulting in weaker demand for oil pipes, is there any plan to tap water segment more compared to oil and gas sector?
So our order book is broadly split between water and oil and gas. And in terms of volumes, very equally, literally 53% is the water order book. Almost 47% is the oil and gas order book globally. That's what we're talking here. All put together, around 7.5 lakh tons of order book, what we're talking. We are seeing emergence of water sector and we are completely focused on that. And just to assure all the members that we are not missing out on any opportunity which is coming on the way, either in terms of oil and gas or in water.
We'll take the next question. The next question is, what is impact of COVID-19 on the company's performance?
Answer?
Yeah.
See, the operations of the company and its subsidiaries were impacted due to shutdown of all plants and offices following lockdown imposed by the government authorities to contain the spread of COVID-19 pandemic. The company and its subsidiaries have since then resumed operations in a phased manner and are operating in accordance with the health and safety guidelines as issued by the respective government authorities. As of now, all the plants are fully operational and the COVID-19 impact has been mitigated to a large extent. On top of it, we are taking all necessary precautions as what are necessary to keep our employees, stakeholders, service providers safe.
Thank you, sir. Taking the next question. Please provide update on plate and coil mill division divestment.
As you are aware that we have, you know, the parties have signed a business transfer agreement for the sale of our asset PCMD, and both the parties have reiterated their commitment to consummate this transaction on or before 31st March of 2021. Further, as we have earlier informed, the company has also received an advance amount as per the understanding for the FOCI transaction.
So next question is on progress on Bhopal project. Where are we on the Bhopal project? The next question.
So as we informed earlier, the Bhopal pipe plant is fully ramped up. It is fully in operation, fully functional. The Bhopal coating plant is also completed. As we speak, I am very pleased to report that it has a considerable order book, and which is being, those pipes are getting coated at a Bhopal plant. So the phase one of Bhopal project is completed in all respects. And both the pipe plant and the coating plants are fully operational. Further, if you would have noted that, you know, looking at the business prospects and the optimal utilization of our assets, we have also relocated one more plant from Anjar to Bhopal, and that is currently under commissioning. And I am very hopeful that by the third quarter of this year, that plant would also be fully operational.
Thank you, sir. Next question is, how has the company managed exchange rate fluctuations?
As a policy, the company always hedges their foreign currency exposures, and there is a well-defined procedure for hedging. We do not speculate at all whatsoever on the hedging side, on the currency side of it. So at this point of time, we are completely hedged. Other than some mark-to-market movements, I don't think so there is any other exposure which the company is currently exposed to.
That's it. These were some of the key questions. The questions, if any, we can.
Thank you. My advice, the company is ready to conduct the voting procedure. Therefore, the voting will be announced on or before September 18th, and the same will be communicated to the policy. It will be available on the website of the company and the NSPS. In that, I would like to once again thank the members and my colleagues on the board and other dignitaries, and conclude this annual general meeting of the company. Thank you very much. for joining with me. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.